Nobody wants to mess up or ruin their project, like so many people are afraid to use modeling paste. That's why I made today's video, so it could help you gain the confidence to use modeling paste, as I will be sharing lots of helpful tips. I will not only show you what not to do, but I will create an art journal page and show you what you should do. Now let's get started. Tip 1. Use a palette knife or silicone spatula. It might seem obvious, but you need a flat edge tool to apply the paste. You could probably use an old plastic card as well, but I prefer the silicone material as it's softer and doesn't get caught in the edges of a stencil, if that's what I'm using. Tip 2. When applying paste on your surface, whether through a stencil or not, it's best to grab a little bit at a time. You can always add more, but having too much on your knife makes it hard to smooth out the paste. Tip 3. Don't apply a thick coat through a stencil. Applying it too thick will make the texture look uneven and it will take way longer to dry, which leads me to the next tip. Tip 4. It is so important to fully dry the modeling paste. Otherwise, if you spray or paint while it's still wet, it will completely smush and you will lose the texture and design. Tip 5. If you want to add color to your project like acrylic paint or spray, you can dry your surface and then apply on top. You can also mix the white paste with either acrylic paint or mica powder to create a desired color. I've even mixed it with coffee grounds and created an amazing brown texture for one of my projects. Some companies even make their own colored pastes in gold, silver, bronze, or black, and they work amazingly through the stencils or on their own. Tip 6. Extending or moving the stencil pattern. If you stenciled an area with paste and then want either to move your stencil to add more texture or add a different color of modeling paste, like I'm doing here, you have to make sure you dry first before moving the stencil. Otherwise, the stencil will ruin the design. If you make a mistake when applying paste, you can remove it right away if it's still wet. But if it's dry, you can carefully use a palette knife and remove the paste like I'm doing here with this triangle that I felt was out of place. Then I use white gesso to cover it up, which makes it look like it was never there. Now comes my favorite tip and why I love paste so much. Adding color makes everything pop and the 3D texture starts revealing itself. You can do several techniques here, like painting with acrylic paints, watercolors, or like I'm doing here by using spray paints, which is my favorite technique. I love how the spray runs between the paste texture and creates depth with shadows and highlights. One of the most amazing properties of pastes is that they resist water-soluble mediums like sprays or watercolors, as the paste is made of polymer plastic. So you can easily remove some of the spray from the elevated areas, and so the shadows and highlights become more prominent. Using sprays comes with its own challenges, and many people are afraid to use them. That's why I created this video right here with the do's and don'ts of sprays, which will help you avoid any frustrating mistakes you might encounter while using them.